You are welcome in chemistry classes by K.K. Singh Minerva Public School, Basantpur. Today we will study peroxidation reduction reaction. We have already discussed some different type of chemical reactions. One of the most important type of chemical reaction is oxidation reduction reaction. We collectively call it redox reaction. Initially, it was believed that addition of oxygen or removal of hydrogen. Keep in mind, addition of oxygen or removal of hydrogen is oxidation, and addition of hydrogen, removal of oxygen is called oxidation. But nowadays this definition is not sufficient. We will define oxidation as the addition or increment, not only addition but increment, addition or increment of oxygen or any other electronegative elements or radicals. Electronegative elements are fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, oxygen, etc. Electronegative radicals are sulfate, carbonate, etc. These are electronegative radicals and these are electronegative elements. When any of them increases in a compound, it will say to be oxidation, and their decrease or removal is said to be reduction. We see that oxidation and reduction are opposite to each other. In case of reduction, addition of hydrogen or electropositive. Electropositive, all metals, metallic ions are electropositive. Aluminium, sodium, calcium, magnesium. If these radicals are electropositive, and also NH4, ammonium, and PH4, these are also electropositive radicals. If they are added, means if this, any of these is added to a compound, it will be reduction, and any of them will remove from the compound is oxidation. Similarly, any of them, this added or increased in a compound, it will be oxidation, and their removal is reduction. Modern theory of oxidation and reduction is electron theory, which we will discuss in higher classes. Means loss of electron is oxidation, but oxidizing agent receives electron, and gain of electron is reduction, but reducing agent gives electrons. This theory we will discuss in higher classes, 11, 12. In our classes, we will study the definition of oxidation and reduction, and we have to identify where the oxidation take place or reduction take place. But if one thing is very important, if there is oxidation, there must be reduction. If anyone oxidize, means other reduce. If this oxidized, means this is reduced. Oxidation will not take place or not occur without reduction, and reduction will not take place without oxidation. Similarly, if there is no borrower, there will be no money lender. If there will be no money lender, what is the utility of borrower? Therefore, borrower and lender, borrower and lender must be in the society same way. If there is oxidation, means there must be oxidizer, then there will be reduction. Therefore, oxidation and reduction occur simultaneously together, not separate. But we will study one by one. First, we will study oxidation and then reduction. Take an example. Suppose H2 hydrogen. If O2 is added to hydrogen, it will becomes H2O. Means H2 oxidize. H2 oxidize H2O. At the same time, hydrogen has been added to oxygen, means O2 has reduced to H2O. Thus, oxidation and reduction take place together. We will study oxidation first, one by one, then reduction, in next video.